Louisiana Living on Fox 14 continues.
And welcome back. I'm joined now by Bobby Carney with LifeShare Blood Center, and he's here to talk about an additional replenishment blood drive for Matt Branch here in Monroe. Bobby, thank you so much for joining us again to talk about this additional blood drive that's going to be taking place at First National Bank in Monroe. What are the times?
I think we're doing that one from 10 to 2 at First National Bank of Monroe. We've also got one going on this weekend. We've also got one going on at Neville High School. So there's like three more blood drives that we're doing for Matt Branch. I would just ask you that that anyone interested in going to these blood drives would go to our Facebook page. We're at LifeShare Blood Centers Monroe on Facebook, and you'll see all of our upcoming blood drives. Also, there's some other than Matt Branch that you'll see. We're in CrossFit. We're in, we're going to be in the Bastrop area, of course. We're also going to be doing a blood drive, another replenishment blood drive, actually, in Ruston for Scott Collins, who was also injured in a pretty horrific accident. So just go on to that Facebook page. You'll see all those upcoming drives. You can actually go to our website, lifeshare.org. You can make an appointment and show up, and we'll get you squared away.
And talk to us more about what replenishment blood drive is.
Sure. And I think that the family of Mr. Branch really wanted me to reiterate that that had the blood not been on the shelf, that he wouldn't be here today. So they want to just emphasize the importance of donating that blood so that other families in our community will have blood when they need it. Mm-hmm. And so that's really what a replenishment is. We're basically just filling up the bank. And so that when the hospitals come calling, we'll have that blood for our local families.
What's the status right now on the blood that we do have?
Well, I'm glad you asked, because we are critical. I'm not allowed to use that word very often, and so when we are critical, it's a pretty bad situation. So we really need all the blood that we can get, and that's not just for the Monroe area. It's for our six other centers that we have. So you see, it's a problem nationwide, really, with our blood supply.
And you said a comment pretty powerful that if you could save a life.
Yeah, that's right. It's if you had the opportunity to save someone's life and it wouldn't cost you a dime and it wouldn't risk your own life, would you do it? Mm. And I think most of us would, right? So we're just talking about 20 minutes to give somebody really a lifetime. I mean, we're talking, if it's a premature baby, you're talking about giving 20 minutes to give that child its first steps, right? Its first home run, its first prom, all those things. And I used, we talked about my grandmother briefly,
yeah.
And who recently passed at 94. And while she didn't need a blood transfusion, but had she needed one at a young age, she wouldn't have gone on to have four children, mm-hmm. who went on to have 11 grandchildren, who went on to have 20 great-grandchildren, and then 21 great-great-grandchildren and counting. So when you give blood, you're not just saving that life and affecting that immediate family around that individual. You're, in a sense, proliferating life. And that's power. That is true power. So I would encourage everybody, if you have the opportunity, to come on out and donate blood and help us save a life.
Well, everyone is invited to come out and donate blood at First National Bank on Monday from 10 to 2. If you and the other locations, which are also listed on LifeShare Blood Center's Facebook page. And if you haven't heard, Matt Branch was critically injured in a hunting accident, and along with the other patient that you mentioned.
Scott Collins.
Also injured, and so these blood drives will help replenish the blood that was used for them.
I just want to point out, blood cannot be manufactured. You can't pick it up at Walmart, and you can't order it on Amazon. It's got to come from these good folks in our community. So,
Bobby, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.
Coming up next, we'll get you ready for all the weekend events. Stay with us.